Hello mga katangkay! Welcome again to Swords and welcome to Elementary Physics. And for Lecture 3, we will be having the forces. So for the forces, of course, we will be talking about Newton's Law. So, sa Newton's Law, matunog na ang pangalang Isaac Newton kasi from that word, kasi yung term na Newton's Law ay kinuha or derived from the surname of Sir Isaac Newton. And Isaac Newton is the one who formulated the laws of motion and universal gravitation that formed the dominant specific viewpoint until it was superseded by the theory of relativity. Besides developing mechanics, including his three great laws of motion and the law of universal gravitation, he also tried to understand the nature of light. So, unang-una sa law of motion is the first law of motion, or what we call the law of inertia. So, the law of inertia states that a body at rest remains at rest and a body in motion will remain in motion or remain in uniform motion in a straight line unless acted on by an external unbalanced force. So, ang example nito is yung tao na nakasakay sa isang sasakyan. And kapag umandar yung sasakyan, the person will move as well. So that is one of the example of the law of inertia. And then kapag tumigil yung sasakyan, syempre titigil din yung tao. Or kaya naman is yung meron tayo dong cart na nakastay or at rest sa isang position, but then dumating yung may-ari ng cart and tinulak niya yun, that means nag-apply siya ng force at a certain direction and yung cart now will be in motion. So that is what, so yun na yung tinutukoy ng first law of motion. It will remain at rest unless may nag-act na external unbalanced force. And it will remain in motion unless magkaroon nga din ng unbalanced force. Next is the second law of motion. So sa second law of motion is also what we call as the law of acceleration. It states that the acceleration of an object in the direction of the resultant force is directly proportional to the magnitude of the force and inversely proportional to the mass. It is also known as the law of acceleration. So, sa second law of motion, ang example nito ay yung pushing a cart twice the force you exert will double its acceleration. So, yung kanina, at rest yung cart sa law of inertia. Pag tinulak mo siya, magiging in motion na siya. And then, kapag nag-increase ka, pag in-increase mo yung force na in-apply mo, of course, bibilis yung takbo ng cart. And then, mag-i-increase din yung acceleration. Then, mag-i-exist yung acceleration. So, sa second law of motion, we have this famous formula which is F is equal to ma, where F is our force, m is the mass in kilogram, and then yung acceleration natin is in meters per second square. So, this is the SI unit that is commonly used in this formula. So, sa third law of motion, it states that every action force, there must be an equal and opposite reaction force. So, dito natin ito yung tinatawag natin na law of interaction. Dito natin makikilala sina normal force, reaction force, wherein every time mag-apply ka ng force sa isang object, ay meron siyang babalik na equal and opposite reaction force. So, example natin is if you climb with a rope, there is a tension force exerted upward and there is a gravitation force exerted downward. Yun. So, yan. We have the problem-solving strategy. So, una, read the problem carefully, then draw and label a rough sketch. So, for me, I don't call it a rough sketch. We should call it home, free body diagram. So, sa free body diagram, dyan mo ilalagay yung mga nag-i-exist na force, line of actions, plane. For example, ay 3D or 2D. So, line of action, direction. So, when you draw a free body diagram, you must take note of these following components. Kasi, sa free body diagram, that will help you to visualize on how you will solve the problem. So, number two, indicate all given information and state what is to be found. Yan. So, it is very important that you are able to classify which are the given an certain problem. Since kung yun pa lang, hindi mo na maklasify yung kung anong klaseng given yun, kung anong quantity yun, then it will be hard for you to solve the problem. So, number three, you construct a free body diagram for each object undergoing acceleration and choose an X or Y axis along the continuous line of motion. So, dapat una pa lang, after mo ma-read na yung problem, you already create the free body diagram. So, this is also the same as this one, the step number one. So, ang una, free, daw mo yung given, then gawa ka ng free body diagram. Then, sunod, indicate a consistent choice of forward for the positive direction along the continuous line of motion. So, ang ginasabi nito ay yung gagamitin mo na condition. So, when you choose na positive ang upward, then lahat ng upward forces ay positive. Pag sinabi mo naman na ang lahat ng to the right ay positive, then therefore, lahat ng to the right ay positive and automatically, yung to the left na direction ng forces is technically a negative direction. So, number five, be careful not to confuse the weight of an object with its mass. Yan. Ito yung common mistake ng mga nung dati pa lang. Mga typical high school. Nakukonfuse sila sa weight and mass. So, sa weight, that is equal to mass times gravity. That is the mass, I mean, that is the quantity, or that is the value of the mass which is affected by the gravity. Yung mass naman, that is the quantity itself of the object. So, yung weight natin, it can vary with it can vary, the value can vary depends on the value of the gravitational acceleration. So, therefore, pag nagdala ka ng pakwan sa buwan, wherein yung gravity dun ay lesser than the gravity here in Earth, then therefore, mas mababa yung weight ni pakwan doon sa buwan. I mean, buwan. But then, yung mass nun is constant. Hindi siya magbabago. Since that is the yung mass nun ay yung mismong quantity ng object na yun. So, number six, from the free body diagram, determine the resultant force along the assumed positive line of motion. So, yan. So, after mo madrasi free body diagram kanina, you will be able to determine what is the resultant force by computing the sum of the forces. So, by the sum of the forces, we mean So sum of the forces, we mean that you will take the sum of the mass times the acceleration. So that comes with the problem solving strategy number 7 and number 8. Number 7, determine the total mass of the system, that is mass 1 plus mass 2 plus mass 3. Then until kung hanggang ilan yung given. Number 8, set the resultant force equal to the mass times the acceleration. So, I told you earlier na ang for the mass that F is equal to ma. So, when you are given with many quantities of forces, you will add ang formula mo ay ang mangyayari ay yung acceleration times yung sum ng masses ng system. Then two. And then if you want to solve naman for the individual forces for each quantity, then you must use again. You can still use the formula F is equal to ma. Ang mangyayari lang, F1 is equal to M1A, then F2 equals to M2A. Masunod tayo, substitute all given quantities and solve for the unknown. Yan. Dito yun mangyayari, yung may mga unknowns tayo sa problem, and then you will use this formula to solve for the unknown. After mo makuha yung mga kailangan mong values. Next tayo. Yan. So we are now here at problem 1. 0.150 kilogram particle moves along an x-axis according to x of t, which is equal to negative 13.00 plus 2.00t plus 4.00t squared minus 3.00t cubed. With x in meters and t in seconds. So, in unit vector notation, what is the net force on the particle at t is equal to 3.4 t seconds? So, we are given here a position function. So, meron tayong x of t. As you can remember from your, kung naalala nyo, ang x of t natin is equal to our position. And to get the acceleration, diba, ang gamitin natin dito ay f is equal to ma. And f is what we are looking for. M is already given, which is 1.5. And then, meron tayong position function. And for us to be able to solve for the acceleration, kailangan kasi natin ng value for acceleration. And we cannot just use the 9.8 since we are given here a position function. And the result may vary. So, to solve for that, we all know that the position is equal to s. And x prime of t, or the first derivative of the position, is equal to the velocity. And the second derivative of the position is equal to the acceleration. Therefore, to solve for the acceleration, we will be just getting the second derivative of the given function, which is the derivative of x of t over dt squared. Yan. So, I hope natatandaan nyo pa kung paano kumuha ng first ng derivative. So, kuhanin man natin si x prime of t. So, sa x prime of t is, so, first derivative ni negative 13, so that is 0, plus 2, plus 8, t, minus 9t squared. So, ngayon, meron na tayong first derivative. Ang next natin is the second derivative, which is the acceleration na. So, that is 0, and that would be 8 minus 18t. So, this is our acceleration. But then, we still need the numerical value. So, we are given t is equal to 3.4 seconds. So, at x if t is equal to 3.4 seconds, therefore a is equal to 8 minus 18.0 times 3.40. So, calculate natin. Okay, yung calculate ko. B8 minus 18 times 3.40. So, our acceleration is negative 53.2 meters per second square. So, that is the unit for acceleration. So, ngayon, meron na tayong acceleration. Meron din tayong mass. And, knowing ng ating mass is equal to 0.150 kilogram. Then, yung ating acceleration is equal to negative 53.2 meter per second square. So, we can now solve for F, which is equal to ma. And that is equal to 0.150 kg times 53.2, this negative, times meter per second square. Therefore, our final answer would be negative 7.98 newton. So, since we, ang sabi ay, yung particle is moving along the x-axis, therefore, if the negative sign means that, our force is equal to 7.98 newton, which is going to the left. So, this is the final answer for this problem. So, in problem number 2, a 5 kilogram block rests on a frictionless tabletop. A cord attached to it passes over a light frictionless pulley attached to another as shown below. What must be the mass such that the system accelerates at 2 meters per second square? And B, what is the tension in the cord? So, for letter A, what must be the mass such that the system accelerates at 2 meters per second square? We all know the formula for this Newton's second law of motion, which is F net is equal to mass times acceleration. So, if we are to solve for the acceleration, which is ito, mass pala. Sorry, baliktad. So, if we are to solve for the mass of M2, para magkaroon ng acceleration na 2 meters per second, we all know that F net is the same as Mg, M2g. Since sa figure na to, ang mag-exert lang ng force is yung weight na meron si M2, which is yung magkakos ng motion dito sa ating system. Then sa next, we have M, that is the summation of masses, that is M1 plus M2 times yung acceleration, which is given. So, ang pinapahanap sa problem natin is yung M2. Ito. So, we will be deriving a formula here. To solve for M2, we will substitute the values G and A and M1. So, M2 times yung 9.8 is equal to M1 plus, yung M1 natin ay 5 kilogram. It is 5. Plus yung M2, which is unknown, times
yung acceleration which is 2. So, ngayon, we can now solve for m2. So, simplify mo natin yan. This is 4 letter A. That is 9.8 m2 is equal to 10 plus 2m2. Then, we combine 9.8 m2 minus 2m2 is equal to 10. That will be 7.8 m2 is equal to 10. m2 is equal to 10 over 7.8. So, that is equal to, that is 10 over 7.8. So, that is 1.28 kilogram. Are we correct? M2, that is 9.8. Let's check ko lang. 5 plus x times 2. That is 1.28. So the mass of the second block is 128 kilograms, and with this mass, the system can accelerate at 2 meters per second. So our next is yung ating tension in the cord. So, for the tension in the cord, magkakaroon lang ng tension from here. So, in the tension, it is provided that it is from the summation of f of x, which is equal to, so in this figure, that is, ang atin lamang x component is the tension. So from here, we can solve for the tension in the cord. So we all know that the summation of fx is again equal to mass times acceleration. That is equal to t. From this point, ang gagamitin lang natin na value ni mass is itong mass 1. So, that is m1a equals to t. So, therefore, we just substitute the value, that is m1, 5 times yung 2 meters per second. So, that so our tension would be 10 meters per second. I mean, 10, our tension would be 10 newton. That is for problem number 2. So, for the references, these are the references. And thank you for listening. See you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.